Everyone, and here come the hands-on tips we love to bring you at Aging is for Everyone. And we're going to use this example that Saralin Tiedeman of the Millennium Collaborative Care brought to light earlier. So, Saralin, taking this and putting it into practical everyday knowledge that we can use. Let's use that example of someone going home from the hospital with that stack of papers, all sorts of consents, all sorts of paperwork, but really a summary of what's changed.
Yeah.
What do we do? Let's talk about the important things for people to remember. What are some of the problems commonly seen with transitioning from home, from hospital to home?
Mm-hmm.
Or what are the things that people should try to do more of and themselves when doing it? Talk a little bit about that transition from hospital to home.
Sure. So I think one of the key things that every patient should really be thinking about is, who do I have to support me when I'm in the community? And really, you want that person to be with you when you're getting your education and you're talking with the doctor and you're talking with the nurse at the hospital, because, you know, let's be honest, you're not getting a lot of rest in the hospital.
You're not feeling well.
You may be on medications that are making you a little woozy and you're not able to concentrate. You're getting the vitals taken every hour on the hour, God love them, but, you know, it's hard for you to really pay attention and remember everything that you're being told. And like we just talked about, the discharge printouts and the summaries, they're very lengthy. You know, we've really been working with our hospitals to be writing things at an appropriate reading level, which, you know, really we're encouraging fifth grade reading level is really what kind of the national standard is here for patient educational materials. So we want to make sure that, you know, you can understand what the clinicians or the nurses, social workers, anyone's telling you that you need to do when